too. I had to get a new one too. And by the time I got off work today, I work in West Palm. The fireplace was at 6. But it's like back here. And inside, it's like great stuff. It's showing steel, the wiring.
Oh. Yeah, you could even pay me to do that.
I get it. Not expensive.
You gonna get them off?
I hope so. Should be an issue.
Is that your only jack?
Yeah.
I don't know if it's gonna work on the ground like this.
I should go up to that.
You probably should at least pull up the
gravel.
Well, that's much harder than
the grass.
Yeah.
797.
That's what I would have pulled up to. I've seen it start to sink and then it fall over. After they got the tire off. And then they're stuck because it's like on the ground, no tire. They even messed up there. to make sure it's... Okay. That's good.
Good. How much easier that makes it?
Put them on that tight.
No.
Call whoever put your brakes on and complain.
AAA. The ability to stop automatically?
Yeah.
Yeah. quicker?
Maybe. They might. They have some more tools than I got.
No, I was working. That helps.
Split under there, okay?
Just three. 23 callers in a blue Ford pickup truck.
Hands outside the vehicle. Driver, at this time, open the door and step out of the vehicle. Keep your hands outside the vehicle, driver. Keep your hands outside the vehicle. Step outside the vehicle, sir. Keep your hands up where I can see them. Do you have anything on your person, sir? Go ahead and turn around. Passenger, step outside the vehicle. Keep your hands outside the vehicle. Do you have anything on you at any time? Put your hands on the vehicle. Put your hands on the vehicle, ma'am.
May I ask what this is about?
Okay. I had a report that you pulled out a gun on somebody driving down the road, sir.
That is not true.
Is there any weapons inside the vehicle?
There is. I have a concealed carry.
Okay. Okay, you can have to stand by. Do you have it on you or inside the vehicle?
Yes, the weapon is inside the vehicle.
Okay.
In the weapon.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and search you this time. Make sure you don't have anything on you. Okay, sir. Okay. What is this right here?
It's a copy.
Okay.
And if it was a report by a...
Okay.
They threw things at the vehicle, rolled the window down, and the area threatened.
Go ahead and stand this over.
Northbound 130.
Stand that behind your vehicle. Where is that weapon now?
It's under the passenger seat.
Okay, it's under the passenger seat.
It is.
Stand right here. Ma'am, you don't have any weapons on you? Ma'am, you don't have any weapons on you? Okay, just go ahead and stand over here for me.
And also, I'll be happy to call the city area for you.
Okay, no problem. We'll get that for you firm in a minute. Where is it at?
The weapon?
No, they can still carry.
It's in my wallet, which is sitting on the center console.
Okay, okay.
1530.
Okay. Do you have any reason why they might have said that you had a weapon?
They were throwing things. I mean, you can see the coke that's running off the back of the car. They threw a coke bottle. I wasn't going fast enough in fast lane for them. It made them upset. They came by. The man was a blonde woman. She yelled at us. Yeah, that's it.
Is a concealed weapon and permit and then where's the magazine?
It's in the glove compartment.
The glove compartment. And concealed weapons in his wallet.
I don't know why they would call that in, other than...
Okay. Also, they're calling that you have a gun. The problem is that you actually have a gun in your car.
Okay, well, it was not used as a weapon.
Okay. Where was the weapon?
It was under the seat with the magazine in the...
Did it ever come out?
It never did. Does it make any difference? I'm a priest in the Episcopal Church and she's a theology professor. We're just enjoying the vacation. I'm a retired military.
service the weapon.
65D27 for the drive along. Do you pick up?
10-4-9, please.
X-ray 162-2807 on Christopher Hughes. Yep, 28 for the blue pickup.
54 Riley.
Gonna be out of Florida. 3276 Juliet Hotel on a blue Chevrolet pickup.
That was 3276 Juliet Hotel, 10-4.
That's 10-4.
They threw?
No, I think it was a coke bottle.
it looked like it.
The panel was open. I mean, it just spun all over. It was sticky, whatever it was.
Your victim, Christopher Wiggins, Valley Class E, 6429, Valley Class E, Expires 3, 1825, stand by for your suspect.
He just sped up looking at it.
Do you remember who was in that vehicle? Do you remember who was yelling at you?
A blonde woman, that's all I remember.
Was that the only person in that vehicle?
There was a man and there were sunglasses, that's all I couldn't make out any facial features.
So he was driving?
Yes, a male was driving.
Did they pull a weapon, or did you say anything about a weapon?
I never saw a weapon, never heard anything about a weapon.
Talk about one?
No.
No?
No.
Any idea of why they would say you had one if you never actually pulled one out?
No idea. Other than this. I mean, I've just seen a lot of weird stuff. I was a chaplain for the military police at Fort Hall for 2 years. I've just seen people pull some weird stuff.
Right.
I don't know.
Okay.
Your suspect 6429 as well.
Okay.
All I can tell you is I didn't pull the weapon. I didn't point a weapon. The only time you pull a weapon is when you intend to use it. And God forbid you ever have to. That's my deal.
1020 for round check in the 4. 1020 out of the victim. 1045429. 1020
for round
check.
Thank you.
Stand by. Okay. So what's the, if you don't mind,
yeah. 1 out of North Carolina, also 5429 as well.
Here in Jacksonville. I started, I believe, it's down there. So, he should probably be coming up here to talk to you. And
I'm happy to talk to you.
I'm sure I'll probably want to talk to you and her as well. Okay.
Just stand by. Some water in the car. You might want to grab that.
Where's the water at? Okay. His water is in the car.
I got blown up in Afghanistan. Long story short, helicopter got shot inside of Savannah.
Right. Who, what?
Black
Ops?
It was a Chinook.
Victim.
2011.
And
55. Who was flying in 101?
Right.
No, it was 180.
All right, this part of the call, she advised that the suspect vehicle would check them. She got up next to them, asked them what was going on, why they did that, and that's when they pulled the signal zero. That's what she advised on her 41.
No, I was 80 seconds. I flew out of the wall.
I was 80 seconds. For 1618 or 783 or
I have her inside the vehicle. That's his girlfriend out of town. He's a former chaplain captain. He said they do have a weapon. Clock has it right there. He has the weapon underneath the vehicle. There's no magazine in it. He's saying that he's never pulled the code to have it.
How the fuck would they know that there was a gun pulled?
Right. So, that's I'm just telling you what they said.
So we know they're lying.
They're lying. Okay.
Because how would they have known if a gun was pulled if they said they didn't shoot?
Say it was the driver or the cop?
The driver said it was a male driver, female next to him. According to this guy, he's in the right-hand lane. There's a slower truck in front. He moves over the inside lane. He says he can see Portland way the hell back, so he knows he's got time to come over. He gets over there. This guy comes around him, gets right in front, brake checks him, starts to fly, then takes back off. Goes over to the right lane and starts slowing down. The mother rolls down the window and went, hey, what the fuck are you doing? He gun doesn't point it at her, but points it in her direction and everything. She says it looks like a 9 or a 4. Okay? This cat's turn also has CWP. Once he does that, he pulls his up and has it down at his side, wondering what the fuck's fixing to go down. So clearly, Numbnuts is lying if he said he never pulled it because they described a damn gun. And he's got one. Determine and see if they want to press charge because you clearly got it right here. You pulled it and pointed in their direction. You've got that right there. Okay? Thing to do is Mirandize for that. They're pulling the gun. They described the gun. They could have clearly indicated that he never pulled it. How the hell would they have known he had a gun? So he's got to pull it. Start asking a few questions and begin thinking about it and say, hey, this is the way this is supposed to roll.
Okay. Are we going to read Miranda to
it? I would read it to it. How old the guy is?
Because I'm not going to sit here and play games. Officer, I'm not playing a game. I'm
How would anybody have known? Answer me a question. How would anybody? None of us knew you had a gun.
I don't know.
A female sitting there, you have a gun, and we're just going to pick a red Corvette out on the highway, and it just so happens you have a gun. I don't believe in coincidence. Let's just deal with facts right here, right now, okay? All you got to do is tell me the truth, and we're done with this.
I'll shut it down.
You're trying to tell me you were on it.
I never pulled a gun.
There's no way. How would anybody have known you've got a gun in that car?
I feel like I'm being punished here.
For what?
Having a concealed carry in the car.
There's nothing illegal about having a concealed carry. Let me
question.
Please. If you have a concealed weapons permit that's valid, you've been in the military, why would you have a weapon that is not loaded?
You only load it when you're ready to use it. Is there one in the chamber?
Absolutely. Always.
By the letter of the law.
So, help me understand, what is the law?
The law says you cannot pull a firearm out at another person or point one at them.
So that's good enough.
That's the problem, though, we have here, sir.
I understand.
They could also describe the weapon that was inside the vehicle as well.
Black handgun?
Or the caliber, too. That's hard to be a lucky guess.
Well, all I can say is I never pulled it.
This is a tough one. I'll check again.
Very serious.
I get that. I really do. And frankly, I can appreciate it. Source of
Come
not doing this, I'm doing something else.
Oh, the poor hood, you feel a lot of rattle on.
That's it? So you there? You were there as an Air Force for the Army?
I started out in the Army. Wound up in the Air Force. After the helicopter crash, we kind of hoped that we couldn't get over and stuff anymore. So the Air Force needed priests.
Thank you. driving all the way back up North Carolina.
Yes, you can still run. Just move. Came down to,
you can swing me out exactly on 25, Victor.
Drink all your water, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
65 with Tennessee 27 on the passenger of suspect vehicle.
Careful, Rick.
Out of Tennessee, 126, 87, 27, 12.
Status is showing valid.
I'm going to need to drive.
Sending her over here so I can tell her exactly what to get. I can go ahead and take it for the night. Don't forget that medicine.
Yep, says he has some medication.
Oh, yeah, he's really good.
Oh. You wanna, do you know where it's at? Okay to let her have your watch, Juicer?
Please do.
Yeah.
And
does she know where the medication's at?
She's trying to figure out what it is. Can you send her over here, please?
He wants to talk to you about the medication.
It's just the two big ones.
You want
the levetiracetam and the Depakote. It's the those two and a bag of chips. I have to have that to take again.
Well, they're not gonna let you take the bag of chips inside the jail.
I can't swallow that without it. It's a threat to my life.
Well, they have is it any type of food? Because they have food in jail.
Okay.
They're not gonna allow food to come in.
Okay. Just those two. Thank you, Casey. I love you, dude.
You're
I'm in FHP 2352, that's 2352. Starting mileage is 95522.
Can you tell me what's next?
Martin County Jail, sir, and then... then from there, I'm not sure. That's not me anymore.
But I'm there for the night. Is that what I'm understanding?
Yes, sir.
This is how we do it down in Puerto Rico. I just wanna hear you scream.
First night in jail. Over something I didn't do.
What's your place of birth?
Mariana, Florida.
How do you spell that?
M-A-R-I-A-N-N-A.
And this is your current address in North Carolina, Crystal Cave Drive?
Yes.
Do you know what county that's in?
It's in Anderson County.
Anderson?
Henderson. H.
Thank you.
919-57.
Me arresting you on improperly exhibiting a firearm or dangerous weapon, sir.
Okay, tell me what that means.
Florida statute, any person having or carrying any sword, firearm, electric weapon or device or other weapon shall, in the presence of one or more persons, exhibit the same in a rude, careless, angry, or threatening manner, not necessary self-defense. The person so offending shall be guilty of misdemeanor in the first degree. That's the charge.
Okay. So it's a misdemeanor charge.
That's what it looks like at this time. I don't know. That's what I'm working with right now. I'm sure I'll double check with my sergeant before I leave here, but...
Okay, thank you.
You'll know, because I'm working on the arrest report now, so... I read your Miranda. Are you still sticking with the same story you had before about...
Yeah, man, I never showed a weapon. I never showed a weapon.
You never pulled your weapon out at all, sir?
Never pulled a weapon, never pointed a weapon, never showed a weapon.
Okay.
Stayed under the seat. To these people who are throwing things at my car and threatening me. Do they ride off?
They're getting a statement from them, sir, so... It's always good to call the police when someone threatens you on the road, sir, so...
I get that, and please don't think I'm trying to be antagonistic, I'm not. The circumstances are a bit frustrating, though.
Have you ever been arrested before, sir?
No. I've never even...
Call 65-27 out of Florida for the passenger of the victim's vehicle. Over.
Out of Florida, Southeast Hotel, I'm doing diuretics for 0-0, so we'll go there. Give the 0-0 to Summers County Sheriff. So when they give me this, the case number, I will add it in the diuretics and I will give you a copy, okay?
Okay. Your weight, sir?
160.
160?
Thank you. I shift around back here, I'm in a pretty good amount of pain.
Yeah, you're fine. I haven't put your seatbelt on. I just need to get your seatbelt on before we leave.
Software must be a pain in the butt.
Say again?
That software must be a pain.
Oh, it works better with than not using it. I got somewhere to go tomorrow, out of town for the next 4 days, so I'm going to be up all night now.
Well, it works that way, doesn't it?
Yep, sometimes it does. Your passenger, what was her name?
Casey. 76JH 2000 for passenger car heating the tag is valid is registered to a 24-year-old male named Christopher Lee Hughes and is insured by insured by all named properties and casualty insurance fees.
We get a new license plate?
I'm sorry?
Are you supposed to have a new license plate?
I ordered one that is a North Carolina custom tag.
The WT0704?
If it's Cayman, I don't know it yet. I've been away for a month.
Oh.
I'm working on my doctorate, and I've been away at school.
Here's your Corvette?
4-chain. Thank you.
Is your weapons a Glock?
Yeah.
Your own model number?
I don't.
The weapon information, because it's not in the notes, or I don't know what notes they put it on. Oh, not the other one now? The one. So, not brandishing? I go out of town for the next 4 days, so I'm going to have to finish this whole thing tonight. I won't be back till Monday. I have military leave starting tomorrow. Yeah, but the whole... Yeah, I'll have to... But the other stuff, has to, the whole packet has to be turned in. They can wait till Monday? David, all it has to be is enough to have probable cause, that's it. No, I don't. Okay. Is that 40 caliber? And that's serial GVN-107? I did have it as the other charge. I'll change it to these two. What is that? Yeah. Yeah, because the other one's just a second degree misdemeanor. Thank you.
right, this is the paperwork you needed.
Where's Middleton?
He's back there.
Okay.
Call him on his cell phone.
Okay.
And know if you need anything else.
Where are they gone now?
What?
Are they gone now?
Yeah, they're gone.
Okay.
All good?
Are you going back to talk to Sergeant Middleton?
What do you need?
I'm going to military leave.
Okay.
Tomorrow, so I'm not going to be able to do anything until Monday.
Okay. Just call him on his cell phone.
Okay.
He's back there. But I'll give him a heads up, too. He's
I don't even know where to print out anything. I can't print anything else up because Post 5 is closed.
Use your printer right there, then.
Well, yeah, at the jail, I can print here.
Yeah.
But I can't do the whole report.
The main one you need right now is the arrest report.
Well, I know all they need is the arrest report.
Yeah, that's it.
I know.
And then the other stuff, when do you go on military? Tomorrow?
Well, tonight, probably at midnight.
Yeah.
Because I got to get picked up at 6 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
And I still haven't packed yet. So I still got to go home and spend a couple hours packing.
Right. You're going to have to give him a call.
So,
I'm
not even going to get this report done.
Yeah.
More than likely.
Yeah, the main one is the bringing them in and arrest, and then I guess the other stuff you have to later. You can just, you not scan and copy from here and send it to them so they can print it out in their computer.
Sure.
PDF. You're sending it to them so that they
to
the sergeant, so that he can proceed with the paperwork. He can probably help you out with that.
Yeah, I'm just not going to have time to complete the whole packet.
Okay.
I just won't.
Yeah. Call him. See what he says. Alright. Yeah. Alright, I'll tell you.
Yeah. I was wondering if you want to tell him or you want me to call him and tell him?
No, just call him. Yeah. Because, yeah. I mean, Coulter then should have picked that up.
Any one of us could have done this.
Yeah,
tonight.
He's coming up right now. You want us to tell him to come up to you?
Sergeant Milton?
He's right there, yeah.
Yeah, I can go talk to him.
Okay.
No, that's Gordon.
He stayed back there. Just give him a call.
Okay.
Yeah, but this is where I pulled him over. Now we're gonna have him.
This is where I pulled him over, not where it happened, though.
How far back did it happen?
It started at the 125.
Technically, he would still be taking it to St. Lucie. So Sergeant Martin?
125 is Martin County.
No, but I'm saying you 1015 him in St. Lucie. Because the county line is right after the bridge, on top of the bridge. Did you talk to
Sergeant
about that?
No. No, I didn't. I just was going to take him to Martin County. Actually, they said on the phone I was going to take him to Martin County.
Okay. No, you're good. I mean, I'm just saying. It's like it was a signal one. All right, let me let you know.
No, yeah. Unless you want to write the report and take him.
No, thank you.
Okay.
You already got that half done, right?
What?
Probably got it almost done.
No.
You haven't started?
No, I got everything else, but I don't, because I didn't have this yet. I didn't know what to say. This is what I need to make a probable cause off of, and I just got this 2 seconds ago. I was just handed this to you, to me 2 seconds ago. By Valencia.
Yeah, but right now all you need is a PC, pretty much. You know, outdoors.
This is where the PC comes from.
What about the thing you got from the call, all the information you got from the call?
There's not much in there. Go look on the notes. You'll see like 3 or 4 lines. That's it.
Is that eye evidence?
I don't have eye evidence.
No, I'm just seeing the pills. Is that clear?
No, that's his
medication. That's so I stay alive tonight.
Yes.
Okay.
His medication.
All right, well, I'll let you go. Well, you know what you do. You go to Martin County, they'll take him in, and then you'll be able to do your paperwork. It's not like St. Lucie where you have to attend.
I don't know, I haven't been to Martin County before.
Yeah, they'll let you. You just go in and then they'll take him in and let you write your report real quick. Alright, let me let you get going.
Okay.
If you need me, call me.
If I need you, there's something seriously wrong.
Huh?
So if I need you, there's something seriously wrong.
Why?
Right, because
I don't know.
Alright. Bye, Doris, then.
I get a chance to write one of those?
Going over these real quick, and I'm just going to ask you a few questions. This is all being video recorded.
Of course. I'm aware.
Thank you. You just want to go over again briefly what happened?
What do you want to know?
Just the whole series of events?
Sure. I was driving and came up behind a car, and then suddenly this blue truck appears on my tail, very, 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 very close to the car.
Which lane were you in?
I was in the left lane at this point. And once the car moved, I went around it, proceeded to pass it, pull into the right lane.
Wait, you were behind him?
I was
in the left lane?
Not the truck, no. The car in front of me, when I passed the car in front of me and pulled into the right lane, this blue truck comes by with a blonde woman in it, beating on the window. And then she rolls the window down and starts screaming.
But what happened before that, though?
Nothing happened before that. I mean, they just came up and got on my tail, and apparently I wasn't going fast enough for them. And it bothered them to the point they were willing to start it.
They were willing to what?
To start screaming at me.
Oh. So you moved over in the right lane to get away from them?
I did. And that's when the blonde white female was hanging out the window, doing obscene hand gestures and screaming at me. And that's when she threw something at me and hit my car. I assume it was a Coke or a water bottle or something of the sort. There was liquid in it. Hit the windshield, went all over the place, had to use the windshield wipers for quite some time. And then I stepped on the gas and sped away from them. And then in 10 minutes, you pull me over.
And did you see a weapon, or?
I never saw a weapon. If they had one, I didn't see it.
And your weapon was?
Under the passenger seat of the car the whole time. Never pulled, never displayed.
I'll be out of the loop after tomorrow. I won't have my phone or anything. Yeah. Okay. That's where I was gonna go. Everything's Martin County, more or less. What is that? Look, Martin County won't take the gun. It never has. St. Lucie's the only one that will take it. But it's at the St. Lucie Sheriff's Office, too. Because the Martin County Sheriff's Office will take it. Yeah. Okay. We'll talk to you later. All right, bye.
I have one question, if I may.
1 second, please. AC, that's 51 to park on a CJ 40. By policy, everyone that's in the back has to drive with us. There, I can't. No worries, I can. Thank you.
final fusion spot?
10 minutes.
As to what happened here tonight. Was it the sergeant on duty?
No, it was really the witnesses. The witnesses that made the claim.
Okay.
It's based on their witness.
Based on their story.
Where's your sally port?
You go around that way.
That way?
The boat, like follow the boat around to the left, and then you just push the button and tell them you've
got. Okay. They don't mind taking them and then coming back and doing the paperwork?
Do the paperwork in there.
I'll take my laptop with me?
Yep.
Okay.
We'll be able to go back and push your car if you need to go open the doors.
Okay.
We're all good.
All right. Did you do a UE in?
Yep. There's a big boat right over here.
Just outside?
Yeah. Just going towards that back gate. Go left around. And then you should right through it.
Okay.
See you, Paul.
All right. Thank you. Get you inside there and out of the handcuffs. FHP, 1 Whiskey Mike. I've never been in this jail before.
Me either.
I've been to a bunch of other ones, but not this one.
Me too, usually as a visiting priest.
Thank you.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah. Just walking around my door.